or a season where it looks like you're going through all kinds of difficult problems. You got to realize that they're just seasons. And when you realize that they're just seasons, you don't get all bent out of shape when things happen. You don't begin to say that I'll never be this or I'll never have this. Or you don't begin to go into a pity party because you realize that you're only going through a season. And so as Christians, we must learn how to operate in the season that we're in. And we must have a mentality that we go through different seasons. The author said there's a season for this and a season for that. And so some of us are in a certain season. And depending on what kind of season we're in, it kind of gets us into the mindset, well, will I ever get out? Will I ever overcome? Will I ever get out of this? And you got to realize that this is only going to be for a certain period of time. That after this period of time, there is going to come a change. So we need to learn how to operate in the seasons where we are. And not only learn how to operate in the seasons where we are, but we need to learn how to get the full benefit of the seasons that we are in. Because no matter what season we are in, God is trying to use it to teach us something, one, and two, to prepare us for our next season. Have you ever noticed that when you're going through a whole lot of time, things are just happening all over the place, you have a tendency to draw closer to God? Have you ever noticed when hell is breaking out all over the place, you have a tendency to pray a little longer, to read a little harder, to do things a little that brings you a little closer to God? God wants to use that season to get you closer to Him, to give you some nuggets, so when you go into your next season, you are ready and you are prepared. Because a lot of times when you go through a season of difficult time, then comes the season of blessing. But why the season of difficult time? So you can grow closer to God. So that when the seasons of blessings come, you don't lose your mind and forget about it.
Well,
see, when you grow closer to Him in the season of difficult times, when you get into the seasons of blessing, you are appreciative and you are grateful that God brought you out of that season of hard times, and you don't forget about Him, but you praise Him even more because He brought you into a better season. So we need to realize that no matter what season we are in, God is using that season to prepare me, to mold me, to shape me, to make me better than I am, and then prepare me for the next season I have to go into. And when we don't have that mentality, we run out of one season into another season, and we are not prepared for it, and then do not reap the benefits of the next season. And a lot of times if we're in a bad season, we're too busy complaining about the season to get the benefits of the season God has for us. Because we don't go through things for nothing. Contrary to what you may think, because you may be going through for something right now, we don't go through something for nothing. It is something God is working on you on the inside. Trying to build some type of character. He's trying to work on you. And you don't go through this season for no reason. But we have a tendency to run through a season and don't reap the benefits. Because our mentality is not that this is only going to be a short period of time. Our mentality is, when am I going to get out? When am I going to get out? When am I going to get out? Lord, please deliver me now. And God is saying, you're so busy trying to get delivered, you can't see the benefits of what you're going through right now. You can't see if I'm building patience. You can't see I'm building endurance. You can't see I'm fortifying your love. You can't see I'm getting you to a new level and a new height. That I'm trying to show you something in the midst of your season. Because every season has a purpose. It's trying to get us ready for something. Trying to propel us for the next season. And we must have the mindset that we are only going through a season. And when you have that mindset, you don't panic. You don't pull your hair out. You don't have pity parties. You say, okay, I'll bear this because my change is about to come. There are some lies that the devil have told us because we have not realized that we are in seasons. Can we just expose some lies this morning that the devil have us. There's some lies that the devil has told us in another part. There's some things that we have said out of our mouths to cause our seasons to last a little longer than they should. There's some things we have said out of our mouths that have caused us to transition into a season God didn't have us to be in at this particular time. Because you are saying some things out of your mouth and you're bringing some things to pass. Let's deal with some lies that the devil have told us. The first one the devil told us, or maybe even church told us, trouble lasts always. You know the song where it said, the storm don't cease, I'm anchored in the Lord. But the storm always stops. A storm never keeps on going. There's always an end to a storm. Although you may feel like the storm is not going to end, although you may feel like the trouble you're in is always going to last always, trouble does not last always. But we can feel that way if our conversation is the wrong way. If we are always talking about the storm, if we're always saying that we're never going to come out, we are causing our season to last longer than God had called it, the morning to last, because we are causing it with our minds to stay a little longer. We got to realize trouble don't last always. The trouble I'm going through is only for a season, only for a certain period of time. Trouble does not last always. Another lie that the devil likes telling us is that nothing good ever happens to me. When you're going through things, you get that mentality. And it always happens to somebody else. Somebody else always gets the raise. Somebody else always gets the job. Somebody else always gets this. That's a lie from the pit of hell. You may go through a season where you may not see any growth. But God may be training you and getting you ready so that when he brings you to your next season, your growth moves rapidly and you move faster than anybody else. You got to realize what season you are in and what is God trying to prepare you for. No, you can't let the devil tell you that lie that nothing good happens to you just because you're going through something right now. Don't let the devil put it in your mind. Don't let it come out of your mouth. When it begins to come out of you, let the devil know, this is just a season. And my change is just around the corner. Another lie the devil tells us is when something good happens, there's always something bad that's going to happen right around the corner. He tries to tell us, I get a blessing here, but something else messed up here. God blesses me financially here, but something messed up here. Why is it messing up? What is your conversation? Did you just speak your car to break down? Oh, God. Did you just speak the drive to go out? Did you just speak the wrong thing? Because every time you see something good, you cautious. That's something bad, something bad's wrong. Because the devil has us in the wrong mindset, and we bring up the wrong things that are going to happen. We got to realize it's a trick of the enemy. The enemy cannot cause me to have pain for something God wants to bless me for. Now, yes, he may try to cause me to not receive or delay my blessing, but only if I allow him to. And trouble may come up, but when trouble comes up, it makes me realize what's about to come is a blessing. What I'm about to walk into is greater than what I'm going through now, because he wouldn't be acting up if I wasn't about to walk into something. He wouldn't be acting up if a blessing won't round the corner. He wouldn't be acting up if I wasn't about to minister to somebody and help them get their deliverance. He wouldn't be acting up the way he's acting up if there wasn't something happening around the corner. But the devil wants to make us think every time something good happens, something bad happens. No, the devil is a liar. I can walk in blessing after blessing after blessing after blessing all the days of my life. And although he may try to kick up against me, I'll kick him back because God is on my side. Too many church people have the wrong mentality. Every time he hears something good, they're looking around. I know the devil is somewhere. I know he's coming.
Put up that defense. We as saints need to do the same thing. When God delivers, when God brings us up, put
That we have had too many times to be running rapid in our lives. Too many times that we've been doing all he wanted to do, and we have been helping him do it.
God, stay right there.
We've been helping him do it. We've been having a long confession come out of our mouth.